Hello everyone. Welcome to Ortho Implants for Life. This week, we will discuss implants and instruments related to both bone forearm fracture and its uses. So let's begin.
Today we will discuss about both bone forearm fracture and all the implants and instruments related to it and its uses. There are multiple plates used to fix both bone forearm fracture. To start with, this one is a small dynamic compression plate, generally known as a small DCP. This is a 10-hole plate. It is available in different sizes, starting from 5-hole to 10-hole. Depending upon the company, there can be small DCP more than 10-hole. This is typically used for radius fractures. Next, this is a recon plate or reconstruction plate. It is used to fix both radius and ulna fractures. This is also available in different sizes, starting from 5 holes to 10 holes. This one is a 10-hole plate. Next is a small DCP locking plate, that is small dynamic compression locking plate. This one is a small DCP non-locking, and the above one is a small DCP locking plate. They both are different, as locking plate has got combi holes. That means it has got both a locking hole as well as a dynamic hole or a non-locking hole. Next, this is a 1/3 tubular locking plate. This also has combi holes and available in different sizes, starting from 5 hole, goes up to 12 holes depending upon the manufacturing company. We will now discuss the screws involved. We will require 3.5 mm cortical screws and 3.5 mm locking screws. This is a 3.5 mm cortical screw, which only locks in the bone. And this is a 3.5 mm locking screw, which gets locked in both the plate as well as the bone. Now, if at all you need to fix the cancellous part of the bone in a both bone forearm fracture, then you might have to use a 4 mm cancellous screw. The pitch of the cancellous screw is a little broader than the cortical or the locking screw. All these screws have different and distinguishable features. So on the extreme right, it's a 3.5 mm locking cancellous screw. On the extreme left, it's a 4 mm full thread cancellous screw. This one is a 3.5 mm cortical screw. And lastly, this is a 3.5 mm locking screw. Coming back to the plates, 1/3 tubular non-locking plate are also used in fixation of a both bone forearm fracture. Each of these plates has got a locking version and a non-locking version. This one is a reconstruction locking plate or a recon locking plate. The below one is a recon non-locking plate. As you can see, there is a difference. The locking plate has got combi holes, whereas a non-locking plate has just got the dynamic holes or the non-locking holes. Now we will discuss about the instruments required for the fixation of a both bone forearm fracture. To start with, we will require drill bits. For non-locking screws, we will require a 2.7 mm drill bit. and 2.8 mm drill bit for locking screws. For drilling purpose, we will require a loaded neutral drill guide. This end is the neutral end, and this end is the loaded end. The loaded end helps you with the compression. For example, for this small DCP plate, if it is getting fixed easily, we will fix the neutral end of the drill guide to drill through the hole. And if you require to do any kind of compression, you will have to fix the loaded end of the drill guide on the plate in order to achieve compression. For a non-locking screw, we will require a 3.5 mm bone tap. Might require to do some tapping after the drilling. We will require a depth gauge in order to measure the length of the screw required to be fixed. In case of a locking plate, if we are required to fix a locking screw in the locking hole, we will require a locking drill sleeve, fix it in the locking hole, and then drill with a 2.8 mm drill bit through the sleeve. In order to fix any screw, we will require a 3.5 mm solid screwdriver. And in order to do the final check for a locking screw, we will require a 3.5 mm torque limiting screwdriver. As explained in our previous videos, you just connect the torque limiting screwdriver in the locking screw. You keep tightening it until it makes a click sound. Once you hear the click sound, it means the screw is completely fixed and cannot be tightened anymore. Now coming to general instruments, in order to fix a both bone forearm fracture, we will require a periosteal elevator. Couple of Homan's retractors. A pair of bone holding clamps or bone holding forceps. Then a pair of self-centering forceps. This also helps to hold the plate with the bone. We need two of these. We also might need a Lohmann's bone clamp. This also helps to hold the plate with the bone in the fracture site. Like this, if you consider this finger to be the bone, it will help to hold the bone and the plate together in the fracture site, and thus making it easier to fix the screws. And lastly, we will require a pair of plate bender. At times, the curvature of radius or ulna does not match with the bone. In such scenario, this device comes handy to bend the plate. Like for this plate, it is straight. We have to fix the plate benders like this and bend the plate like this. We have to keep two of such plate benders. And one of the most vital piece of equipment are K-wires. We have to provide three pieces of each size, starting from 1.8 mm till 2.5 mm. So that will be all for both bone forearm fracture and the related implants and instruments.
If you've enjoyed the video, like it, share it. If you are new to our channel, subscribe it. Hit the bell icon to get the notifications for our upcoming videos. If you have any queries, comment below and we will surely reply back. If you want to know more about career prospects in orthopedic implant industry and wish to start a career in orthopedic implant industry, please click the link below in the description box and DM us to know more. Thank you and see you in our next video.